Hello guys, and welcome back to Custom Gamer. This is the show where we talk about level design while playing cool maps. Today we're playing a new Quake 1 SP by Sock. Really doesn't seem like that long since he released his last one, which of course was Midnight Stalker. This is his new one, Backsteen, and it is amazing. I love this map. And we're going to talk about why in just a moment. But for now, you should just download this and play this and enjoy it. It is a masterpiece. So without further ado, let's go and have a look. So as with all of Sock's Quake 1 maps, there's a lot of mechanics going on here. A lot of them are very, very subtle. A lot of them are explained visually, and you have to be paying attention to various colours and the way things interact. Things like that to understand them all. I didn't catch them all on my first time through, but on the second time through it became very, very apparent how certain things worked. Let's just talk about the start area for a moment, because it's really, really interesting to have a look at. So it's a standard kind of skill select. You jump up a wind tunnel to select your skill, but then you're given the option to go back down here if you're paying attention, and you can actually find a couple of secrets before you even get into the map proper, which I thought was really, really fun. And you're kind of introduced to the first mechanic here. You've got a lift that was in the upright position when we were down on the floor, and you can kind of lower it down using that button. And I believe that kind of visual motif is used on a couple of other ladders, so it's kind of, it's always giving you little hints about how things work and what things look like, various lifts and things like that. So here we go into the map proper. And of course, in Sock style, you're given access to a super shotgun in the first room if you can find the button to activate it. I couldn't find it. I looked around this room for absolutely ages and I just could not find the button for this. I'm guessing it should be one of the simplest secrets to find, but I just can't find it. I've looked absolutely everywhere. So yeah, this is kind of an early access to a weapon secret, so you don't have to wait too long until you gain access again to a shotgun, but this is just kind of annoying. So this area is really interesting. It kind of shows you a lot of different mechanics very, very quickly, so you have to be really paying attention to it. The first of which are these ammo pickups on the floor here, with these kind of green runes underneath are respawning ammo. And you don't really pick up on this at first, but you kind of notice the respawning sound in a couple of rooms. And if you're paying attention to the colour of the flooring underneath these pickups, you'll notice that they're all the same. This is the kind of stuff you really have to pay attention to in Sock maps, is that everything is there for a reason. It's very, very kind of explained through the visuals rather than, you know, on-screen blocks of text and things like that. So you've got a couple of secrets here as well, if you find them. This is another motif. You get these kind of gargoyle heads on the walls, and that there's always kind of a hidden area behind them. It's just a case of finding out how to activate it, which is another kind of motif in the map. And the second motif you'll find is these kind of orange runes on the ground underneath some weapons and pickups. They tend to spawn either traps or enemies. And again, this is something I didn't really pick up on my first time through the map either, but upon reviewing this video in editing and playing the map a couple more times, it's you get used to it after a while. So this is hard skill. It's also my first playthrough of the map, so there might be a couple of cuts here and there where I'm kind of wandering around aimlessly in an area for a bit, trying to work out where a secret is or something. So I've cut out a lot of that stuff for your viewing pleasure. So I like the fact that you're given an option where you want to go first. So you can go and get the silver key, which is kind of the standard progression through the map, or you can go for the gold key, which is a lot more difficult. There's kind of a lot more enemies, a lot tougher enemies, but of course you're going in there early, so you haven't got the same amount of weapons and armor and things like that. But it's great that it gives you the option. Do you notice here you had those yellow runes on the floor underneath that armour? When you pick it up, you get a bunch of enemies teleport in. So we're going to go and grab the silver key now. That's a really tricky secret there. You're just not expecting it to be there. So I missed that one. I'm guessing it opens that grate there so you can grab the armor. Another kind of classic motif that Sop uses a lot in his maps is just having a simple area like this kind of divided into different heights so the player can kind of jump around. It's quite cool. I mean, this area could have very easily just been a kind of flat area with no kind of stairs or, you know, little jumps or anything, but I think it just makes it more interesting having to navigate the environment with more than just kind of moving around. You have to do a jump here and there. I think that's kind of cool. So there's another gargoyle there that opens up if you can find the secret. And it's great that Sock shows you a couple of easy secrets early in the map. It gets the player into the kind of attitude of, right, I've got to search for buttons and secrets and all this kind of stuff. It gives you a couple of freebies early on. It just gets you into the mindset. I love this shambler trap here. If you remember in his last map, Midnight Stalker, you were kind of lowered on a platform into three shamblers. It was kind of a panic moment in that map. In this map, it's kind of reversed. You've got the shambler being lowered down on a platform, and if you don't kill it before it gets to the bottom, he's going to come after you. I think that's really, really cool. Kind of got this timed thing where you're kind of relatively safe while he's being lowered down, but you're going to have to deal with him in much closer quarters if you don't manage to take him out. Now there seems to be a little bit of visual weirdness here with the enemies not being lit correctly, so they're kind of pitch black. I'm guessing that's an engine problem rather than a map problem, so I'm using Fitzquake Mark V to record this demo. Play it back. But yeah, I'm guessing that's an engine bug, not really sure though. This is another little motif in the map, is that you're kind of dropped into an area and you have a chance to have a look around and explore a bit before you kind of step into the sight range of any enemies. So here you kind of drop down behind the fiend and you have a chance to plan your attack, see what you want to do. This is used a couple of times as well, especially in big arenas. You can kind of walk around in these big arenas, explore them, find out what stuff does, and then kind of activate the enemies and have the fight. I do enjoy that. Especially when some of the arenas in this map have some fairly involved mechanics with the buttons and things like crushers and traps and all this kind of stuff. It's great if the player can kind of learn how that stuff works before they're put into a high pressure situation. Grab the rocket launcher secret. So, just architecture-wise, the map is very much kind of, it feels very, very designed with the mechanics first. Saying that, it still looks lovely. There's some great brushwork here. I love the way the walls kind of end in rivets that slowly get smaller as they go in, kind of indentation on the way down. It looks really, really nice. And the lighting, I'm not sure if it's colored lighting or not, but it's very, very subtle if it is, but it looks really, really nice. All the yellow lights have this kind of yellow tinge to them. It's not overdone, but it just helps to make the map look a bit different from all the other maps with this texture set. Another trap plate there underneath the super nail gun. Yeah, I don't think I really caught on to the trap plate colours until about three quarters of the way through the map, where there was a spike trap activated by one of these, and you can kind of stand on it and it'll activate the traps. And I think that's when I really kind of got the hang of it. this is kind of an interesting arena. You're kind of completely impervious to damage at the top here, so you can kind of just rain down rockets or grenades, whatever you've got. I just love the way Sock just reuses visual motifs throughout the entire map. So you notice you've got the lifts on these kind of interconnecting struts that go up and down, and then you've got the same thing, same motif used on the platforms that move horizontally as well. So this bridge that was just extended above us, it's got the kind of crisscross pattern on it as well. I'm going to speed this up a little bit because I'm shooting a Hell Knight with a shotgun. It takes a while. I think perhaps one niggle I have is that sometimes it can be quite hard to kind of distinguish platforms when they're in the lowered position. It kind of just looks like a bit of an alcove. Aside from that though, I didn't have any trouble navigating around the map. So that bridge extends, it's just kind of a shortcut back to that old area, as the ground withdrew from us before. Now these vaults that you can unlock are kind of secret areas, but you have to go through the wind tunnel back in the key selector room to actually get to them. I didn't do that in this first run demo, but I did record some extra footage to show you guys how you activate them. But yeah, I completely missed these two rooms in my original playthrough. I'll show you what I'm talking about in a moment when we get back here. They're actually above the key select wind tunnels here. So you can grab some pickups and rockets and things. This is, I guess, if you missed the secrets for the grenade launcher and the rocket launcher, this is how you get them. You just get them a lot later on in the map, which probably increases the difficulty a fair amount. So if you remember in the wind tunnels in the centre of this room here, there's the two key wind tunnels, then there's a final destination wind tunnel which takes you to the final arena in the map. And then there's these two wind tunnels on the side which are inactive at the start of the map. You have to activate them by finding the secrets. And oh shit. And then you can activate the wind tunnels again in this room and fly up to them, grab a secret, some pickups. I think what I did wrong here is I actually activated the wind tunnel button while I was still up the top, so I didn't connect the two together. Which is probably why I missed it there. I'm gonna go and grab the second key now. Just about grabbed that button on the way past. I was ready for it this time. I'm definitely going to have to play this map a couple more times, doing the gold key area first, just to see how tough it is. It'd be like a badge of honour for this map. So in this large room here, we've got our first big arena. And if you played Midnight Stalker, you're probably going to be familiar with this kind of arena layout. It reminds me a lot of the End Arena in Midnight Stalker, so you've got various traps in the centre of the room that you can activate with buttons around the side. I didn't use them too much in this encounter because I figured the buttons would start the encounter in this room. Didn't kind of click that the buttons were connected to the traps in the centre. Although looking at it now, you can kind of see the runes on the floor kind of pointing towards the traps from each button. Which is, again, it's kind of a subtle visual cue as to what the buttons do. I just didn't pick up on it on my first time through here. Of course, if I'd worked out the rune colours by now, I would have known that picking up the item would start the event here as it had the yellow runes under it. There's a really cool use of enemies here. You've kind of got this slow trickle of just knights, which just fill up the arena, which are fairly easy to avoid, but if you don't deal with them at some point, you're going to get stuck in a corner with just hundreds of them on you, and that's going to be like instant death. And then just occasionally, the kind of standard gameplay is changed by having a very, very powerful enemy thrown into the arena. Like, shamblers and boars in arenas like this are fairly dangerous because there's not really a lot of cover you can get behind aside from the traps in the centre. So you really do have to deal with them fairly quickly. So yeah, really cool arena. Enjoyed it a lot. Never found the button to get that quad damage. I didn't even notice the quad damage was there until the arena was over. Yeah, a bit of a shame. So here's where you notice the spike shooters on the wall, but of course they don't activate until you stand on the yellow runes. Grab the invisibility ring, this will be handy. So I think this is where I worked out about the yellow squares, you can see. Unfortunately, I wasted a lot of this invisibility rune because I had to go back and grab that armour. I didn't quite use it to the fullest potential, but hey, never mind. This room seems to get repopulated with enemies all the time as you're fighting in it, which is quite nice. You never really feel safe in it until you've got out of it fully. It's quite well done because you never actually see the enemies teleport in or anything like that. It's just you clear a corner and then when you go back round that corner on your way back through the room, there's just enemies there. It's really creepy. And of course, once the battle really kicks off, he starts teleporting enemies in. Huh. Now getting back to the gold key. That is a gold key, I promise. It's just rendered full dark for some reason. So this is very, very similar to the silver key room, in that you've got the shambler coming down on the platform. So now I'm looking for a button because I've seen that gargoyle head on the wall there. I don't think I find it. I think overall I didn't find very many secrets on my first run through here. I think I've got 3 or 4. Again, I probably could have got 5 if I'd used the vault wind tunnels. Oh no, I do find the button there because it's it's right in his mouth, yeah. There you go, we've activated the gold key vault. So you can just grab the gold key and leave and not activate the vaults, and then you'll never have access to them. I love the way that secrets are kind of got this kind of dual layer secret where you have to activate it and then actually find the wind tunnel for it and use it. So there you go again, I've activated the vault without actually going down there, so that's probably why I never pieced it together. Kill these guys. I like the way that this room gets such reuse. You come back to it 3 times, I think, altogether. There's always repopulation of monsters here, there's always a decent fight. With the vaults here as well, you get new gameplay every time you come back to it as well, so it's very, very nice. So I'm going to splice in some footage here of the vaults just to show you guys what I'm talking about. So here we are, this is the vault before you activate the buttons in the key areas. You see they're completely inactive, you can't use them. And then I've gone through the silver key wind tunnel and activated the rune vault, which of course activates the button on the wind tunnel. And if you activate it from down here, you notice that it activates and you get the platform come up. It just kind of invites you to jump in. This is the part I missed because I shot the buttons from up above, which gives you a secret area and some items. So back to the map proper. This is the final wind tunnel. Now we're in the final area. I kind of like that it gives you a choice of where you want to go here, so you can kind of explore around a bit, choose a direction. There's the final rune there. And of course you got the yellow runes on the floor underneath it, which denotes that bad things are going to happen when you touch that. This area is very, very similar to the last arena we were in, but it just gets a lot more hectic. It follows the same kind of formula as the last arena as well, so you get plenty of knights, which are the cannon fodder enemy in here. But it's just a lot more, I suppose you'd call them special enemy types, I guess. Things like shamblers, vors, big warpins of ogres. I like the fact that it starts off really slow though, and then just constantly builds and builds and builds. The pacing's really, really nice. This is what I love about Quake, is the fact that you can be in an arena full of enemies, and if you're good, if you keep moving, use the mobility your character has, you can basically avoid almost all the damage if you're good enough. Something I think a lot of modern games really kind of screw up, is that they force the player to take damage, usually because there's a regenerating health system and they have to force the player to take cover or do something different, otherwise they'd never die. Yeah, the Vors are always the cause of concern here, because there's not a lot of cover to get rid of their Vor balls, so as soon as you hear that noise, it's almost like hearing the poison headcrab sound in Half-Life 2. Constantly, suddenly the priority shifts to, oh god, where is it? I have to kill it quickly. Yeah, really fun arena. I probably could have used the crushers more than I did, but I was just kind of panicking at that point. I love the fact that it lets you go back to the start of the level as well, so you can kind of look through the level again, find all the secrets if you want to. That's nice. Which brings us neatly onto the end. So yeah, this is a classic SOC map through and through. Very, very visual mechanics, all kind of laid out in front of you. It's basically up to the player to kind of just notice all the little things in the map which kind of explain how things work. I noticed a couple of them. It took me most of the map to get all of them down, but I got there in the end. But yeah, it's really, really nice presentation. Gorgeous visuals. Great gameplay. The secrets are awesome. It's endlessly replayable. Man, I'll just leave it at that. It's great. So, enjoy this map, guys. I'll see you next time.